Good evening, folks. It's Diamond with the Oppenheimer Ranch Project and Magnetic Reversal News, bringing you a grand solar minimum update Thursday, July 18th, around 9 p.m. Mountain Time, 2024. According to the WSA Enlil Spiral, two coronal mass ejections popping off the sun yesterday may cannibalize each other and bring, well, quite a significant hit on the 20th. That means we're waiting for a geomagnetic storm to hit Earth. Keep calm. It's boom time. Smoke from Canadian wildfires across the Great Lakes as wildfires in Western Canada explode. The smoke may dim the sun and create colorful sunrises and sunsets. Where the smoke is this thickest, it's reaching the surface at times, slightly reducing visibilities and creating a campfire smell. The smoke will also create air quality issues at times, mainly for sensitive groups. We'll jump over quickly to the fire and smoke map, and you can see the densest smoke in North America up in Canada coming from a cacophony of wildfires in the west. And that is obviously dipping down here into the Great Lakes region and making it smell, well, like a campfire. As the southern U.S. braces for a potentially record-breaking stretch of wet, it's going to continue through the end of July. The south is no stranger to afternoon thunderstorms during the summer. However, the upcoming stretch of precipitation will be notable even for them as cities brace for what could be the longest stretch of consecutive wet weather in decades. And here's the full forecast. Areas of excessive rainfall today, dangerous heat redeveloping over the southwest, and dry thunderstorms in the Great Basin. Heavy to excessive rainfall may bring flooding today to parts of the Southern Rockies, Eastern Mid-Atlantic, and Arklatex regions. Dangerous heat will redevelop Friday through this weekend into next week over much of Southern California and the desert Southwest, with dry thunderstorms continuing to pose a threat for new wildfire starts across parts of the Great Basin today and Friday. So heed the warnings. No cigarette butts out the window. Quick look at the total accumulated precipitation, and you're going to see what I mean with this eastern rain. It's already on the ground. It's going to continue to dump through the 25th, 6th, 7th, all the way through the end of the month. Look at the totals here. Up to 10 to 14 inches for some areas of the Carolinas. How do you like them apples? North Carolina could be at flood risks, especially by the end of the month. Let's take a quick look at the GFS model showing the precipitation. You can see pop-up storms in the southwest. They're going to continue for the next 3 hours, reemerge tomorrow, and continue down there in the southwest through the beginning of next week, Monday, Tuesday. It's just going to go on and on. The east and the southeast are going to be pummeled with storm after storm after storm, just like the Energizer Bunny. The Bureau of Meteorology forecasts damaging winds, rain, and hail for snow for Victoria, South Australia. Wow, they continue to get battered with this winter conditions. Most of the country is expected to feel the wintry mix of cold weather and damaging winds as some states prepare for more snow. Ho, ho, ho. I thought there was going to be no more snow. Anyway, seismic update. Couple of rumblers just kicking off on the West Coast, one here in northwestern Mexico, and another, a 3.4 in Morgan Hill, California. Overall, low-level activity worldwide. As we turn to worldwide volcano news for the 18th, we've got Fuego puffing to 15,007, Kaya to 22. Explosive activity continuing here at Ebeco. We've got, following the recent paroxysm events from Etna's Vodajin summit crater on the evening of the 15th, lava flows remain active on the western slope of the central crater, as you can see here from satellite imagery. The lava has branched off into four main arms, of which the northern one is currently 857 meters long. Etna continues with lava flows. Ebu to 8,000 feet, Santa Guido to 14,000 foot today, Liwatobi to 10, Sabancay to 22,000 feet, Sangay to 22, Santa Guito to 14, Mayon on the list today, 9,000 foot puff, Fuego to 15, Ibu to 8,000, Semeru to 14,000, Liwatobi 10,000 foot puff, Sabankaya puffing to 26,000 foot recently, Sangay to 20,000. Wow, big list today. Santaguito to 14, Semeru to 14. What else is on the list? Fuego to 19, Ibeco to 10, and the final report of the day. Well, it's actually tomorrow, so we'll get to that then. And that wraps up Worldwide Volcano News. Quick look over at space weather the last 24 hours. Meager at best. Low-level M-flare there. Not much activity, especially with the sunspot number at 278. How do you like them apples? Mostly just pinpricks. Not really worthy of sunspot designation for many of these, in my opinion. But I do digress. The three-day geomagnetic forecast showing KP4 to KP5 G1 geomagnetic storm the 20th through the 21st. And this is due to a series of coronal mass ejections headed our way. Let's click on that detailed forecast. They're just showing a three-hour G1 geomagnetic storm overnight the 20th through the 21st, which is good news Saturday to Sunday morning. Foreseeing potentially aurora at high latitudes. So get out this weekend if the skies are clear and look up. But continue to monitor our channel for updates, well, on space weather. And here you can see the WSA Enlil spiral. Let me shrink myself down out of the way here. WSA Enlil spiral showing a double CME cannibalizing itself and reaching us sometime midday the 20th or maybe later. Psychedelic mushrooms may have contributed to early development of human consciousness. Some call it the stoned ape hypothesis, but a new study is now concluding that that very well may be true. A new paper exploring the role of psilocybin mushrooms in the evolution of human consciousness says the psychedelic has the potential to trigger significant neurological and psychological effects that could have influenced the development of our species over time. Fantastic. All the links are below in the description box. Now, this paper coming out in 2015, I just wanted to bring it to your attention because I was looking for some data sets to explain the decline of the Native Americans out here in the Southwest around 1350, 1400. And this paper claims unprecedented 21st century drought risk in the American Southwest. They lay over the CMIP6. Just like global warming is going to go straight up, all the rain in the Southwest will go straight down, which makes no sense because if you look at the last 1,000 years of data, the variability is there, but the pattern is linear. And what we can see is a large dip down here through the 1300s, a long, prolonged drought in the desert Southwest, which coincides with the end of people living here right around 1350. Once again, all the links will be below. John Deere drops diversity initiatives. Well, you know the saying, go woke, go broke. Apparently John Deere didn't get the memo, but now they did when the consumers gave them a piece of their mind. Same thing happened with Tractor Supply. It only lasted a few days after they were exposed after the public exposed their woke policies. And John Deere is no different because the majority of people that buy tractors are conservatives, are farmers, and they could care less what your effing pronouns are. As good news, rolling down the woke pipe, Bud Light falls to number three as of yesterday. From number one to number three brand in just a little more than a year after the Dylan Mulvaney controversy. Once again, proving that if you go woke, you go broke, and it lasts for quite a bit of time, over a year, and now the brand is still falling. On to the assassination attempt of Donald Trump. Trump rally gunman purportedly left messages on a gaming platform before his shooting spree. Let's see what he had to say. So on the gaming platform, investigators, according to multiple law enforcement sources, found a post on the gaming platform Steam that is credited to the suspected gunman, 20-year-old Thomas Matthew Crooks, posted July 13th will be my premiere. Watch as it unfolds. Investigators are working to determine whether the post is legitimate, and I would say, based on the activities that happen on the 13th, it is quite legitimate. Now, Thomas Matthew Crooks, the gunman who injured Donald Trump and killed another, searched for both Trump and President Joe Biden on the internet, as well as Attorney General Merrick Garland and FBI Director Christopher Wray in the days before the shooting. He also searched for the phrase major depressive order, which he apparently had. FBI officials revealed this in a briefing with members of Congress on Wednesday. They also found out that, well, the Secret Service had 3 hours of warning once they spotted this kid. So clearly, something is afoot, and someone in the Secret Service or the CIA wanted Donald Trump dead, and we need to get to the bottom of it. The details about his actions before he opened fire at a Pennsylvania rally held by former President Trump over the weekend also come as more details emerge about a chilling message he posted on a gaming platform, which I just told you about. In addition to those searches that we just mentioned, Crooks also looked for public appearances scheduled for both Trump and Biden, according to the New York Times, ultimately landing on Trump's Pennsylvania speech, which was held just 50 miles from his home. And after zeroing in on the event, he reportedly searched for more details on the rally. That's the latest updates as the Biden decision on his future is expected in the coming days. And Harris is considered heir apparent. Who will be Harris's running mate? It's anyone's guess. It's really anyone's guess what's going to be happening at this Democrat convention coming up here. Well, in just a short time. When is it? Does it even say here? Anyway, it's not important. I could care less. But Biden appears to be dropping out very soon. And that could mean the next 4 months could be filled with so many interesting events, well, that may even be catastrophic. And in a time of need, the way that you gain peace of mind is being prepared. Prior preparation prevents piss poor performance. That's the 7 P's. And if you need emergency medications, maybe the Jace case is the way to go. You can get up to 1 year of emergency medications, life-saving medications, and antibiotics to use in a time of need. So if you take insulin or you need some other type of medication, you can get up to a 12-month supply of your prescription for peace of mind. It's preparedness. Create your own and customize your own Jace case, including pharmaceuticals like ivermectin, which you typically can't get from many of these Karen doctors. So go check out our affiliate, Jace Case. Support the channel. Support your preparedness. And support peace of mind for your family, for goodness sakes. And that's a boom to knowledge. Please share the video. We are shadow banned, and we need your help to grow our platform. Hit the thumbs up. It's free. You can even become a Patreon for as little as $1 a month. Watch all of our podcasts in one place, commercial free. We love you. Be safe. And that's a boom.